Well, in my opinion, mascot for the new school should have been the miners.
Miners.
Because in Armstrong County, we do a lot of mining. However, since that is not a choice anymore, I'm going to have to go with the Raptors.
The mascot, new school. Are you ready for this one? The Math Wizards. Absolutely.
Mr. Paul, what do you think the new mascot should be?
Well, after looking at that list, I really like that Miners.
Miners!
But I don't know if that's one of the final choices or not. I'm not too high on dinosaurs or anything with the river in it, but we'll see.
Whatever about the Warhawks.
Warhawks is not bad. Out of the choices that are left, I do like that Warhawks.
So, Mr. Kavanaugh, who do you think the new mascot should be?
Well, I would have been partial to Riverhawks because of the location, but they went with Warhawks. I think I would go right now with Vipers. That would be mine.
Welcome to Education Today. I'm Elliot Zadonik.
And I'm Kelsey Shea.
From Katanning High School in the Armstrong School District. As you know, a new school is being planned to combine Fort Katanning and Fort City into one school. Construction has not yet started, but today we will learn about the other aspects being planned for this new school. To talk about the school, we have a few outstanding guests with us. Welcome to Education Today. Would you please introduce yourself and your role with the committee for the new school?
Hi, I'm Mrs. Gretchen Contrail, and I'm just part of the committee at large. I'm a teacher and a parent in the school district.
I'm Ed Morris. I'm also part of the committee, and I teach at Katanning Senior High School.
Mrs. Contrail, could you tell us what goes on at the committee meetings?
Well, every meeting's a little bit different, but we started out using computers and suggestions that people had brought with them to the meeting to try to narrow down some of the choices for a mascot, which I must say is a lot more difficult than you may think, because there might be 15 people in the room and all 15 people have a different idea of what they do and do not like. So.
And Ms. Contrail, how often does the committee meet to discuss these?
There isn't a set time frame for our meetings. It's a process. So after the first meeting, they had to present things to our school board, and once they presented the ideas to the school board, then we would set up another meeting. They'd present ideas again, and then we'd set up another meeting. So there's no set time period for the meetings.
Could both of you tell us how you all formulate a decision when coming up with the new school colors and mascots?
Well, we went through a brainstorming session, and then we sent the results of our meeting to the technology department, and they formulated a questionnaire and sent it out to the students, and the students had their voice in the matter and voted on
and
the
colors. We didn't come up with the color schemes also. They were presented to us prior to
yes.
our meeting. I think it was a meeting of administrators, and we were given the set of choices. We weren't allowed to use red or purple or gold as part of our color scheme. They wanted to start fresh with something new for the new building. So those colors were not involved in any of the choices.
And then there were colors, the fluorescent green was kind of scratched just because of the availability and the cost.
Silver was
another cost
expensive.
Colors and availability as well. So certain ones were eliminated just based on that.
Okay.
And with that being said, could you tell us what the finalists for the school mascot are?
The finalists were Renegades and Warhawks were the last ones chose.
And what was the committee's reasoning for the reconsideration of the Miners as a decision for the mascot?
I think just with the history of Armstrong County, a lot of coal miners. Of course, the mushroom mines were open as well in the past, and they were, you know, closed down years back. Just the, basically trying to get a little bit of a historical view or a historical perspective of the community.
And they, and also miners had been close in the race. It wasn't shot down by a majority of votes. So since it was close, we went with anything over 200 votes and let it stay on the list.
Okay.
And what are the finalists for the new school colors?
The school colors are determined.
They've been adopted by the school board as well.
Orange and blue. Royal blue, I believe. But
I believe it's royal blue. I think it's Florida Gator color scheme. And orange.
The thing about that color scheme is it's unique to the WIUP-TV, which is what we'll be competing in. So we'll be the only color, those colors, I should say, represented in the whole WIUP-TV.
And regarding the school colors, were they placed on the survey with any historical view in mind?
No. Like I said, the colors came to us as a committee. We didn't get to generate color schemes. They were given to us before we ever met. So I do not know. And like I said, it was hard because red and gold are colors that are used often and are in a lot of color schemes, and they weren't allowed to be part of the mix. And also we had purple, which wasn't allowed to be part of the mix. So that played a role in what they were able to come up with for the finalists.
Very good. And does the new school have a name? Have we come to a school decision?
There hasn't been an official vote on that. That's going to be, we had some input on deciding, a name, but nothing formally has been, voted upon by the school board or anything.
What are some of the ideas that have been pitched?
We've heard, a variety of things. We've heard just plain Armstrong. We heard Fort Armstrong was a suggestion. I think Allegheny, something trying to, they're trying to tie the river in. Mm-hmm. But there's just been suggestions and everything for that so far.
And now we're going to take a short break. We'll be back in a minute to talk more about plans for the new school. Stay tuned.
Before I came to IUP, I had no idea what college would be like or what role I would play or where I'd be in the future. But when I came to IUP, everything changed. I met people who really made me feel like I belonged. I had great classes at a great nationally ranked university. Hi, my name is Megan Miller. I'm a fine arts major, and this is my university.
And we're back with Education Today. Tonight's topic is the new school being made in Armstrong School District. We talked to committee member Ed Morris and Gretchen Contrell, and now we're back with them. But Mr. Morris, could you tell us what your new role is in the committee?
Basically, I was there and aided in the brainstorming session. We had some, feedback from some of the students and everything with suggestions of, mascots. And, you get to hear a whole array of suggestions. Some are popular, some aren't popular. Then we presented them, and it was a process we went through, and certain mascots made the cut, certain mascots did not make the cut. We had a list up. I had fired up the computer. We were looking at the computer at various
college.
Professional college, minor league baseball teams. We looked at, ex-football franchises from USFL.
Another thing, too, that I hate to interrupt you, but they did mention to us we weren't allowed to have any kind of a cat. And so Elderton has the Bobcats, Fort City has the Sabres, Katanning has the Wildcats. So they didn't want any cats. So we had to avoid anything. Bearcats was mentioned, but once again, you're talking cats. I know in the past we had the Cougars. So they just wanted to start fresh and have the three buildings come together. And another thing, when we were talking about colors, we didn't mention also that green was out as a color, forest green, for Elderton as well. So,
okay, and as part of the committee, could both of you tell me how do you feel about the new school coming?
I'm excited.
It's a new start. You can start over again and hopefully build some tradition, with all the communities coming together.
Right, and we both have young children that will be a part of the new school, so I'm looking forward to that. And as you said, new traditions. I know my son and my daughter both have friends from all over that they've done different activities with, so it's nice that they'll all be together in one school. I like that.
And why do you feel like the new school is coming together?
I think because of over the past few years, and it's actually more than a few years, we've had declining enrollment. Combining and consolidating is probably the way to go to save money in the future. And this will allow the kids to have more educational opportunities as well as athletically as well. They'll be able to, you know, perhaps there'll be more teams, all, you know, more sports offered. You can have more teams. And maybe instead of just having like a JV varsity, certain teams that we play and, you know, from other sports will have like a ninth grade team. Then they'll have a JV team. Then they'll have a varsity team. So it should create some opportunities educationally and athletically, I hope.
So, Mr. Morris, I understand that you went to Armstrong Central back in the 1990s. Could you give me some insight about how the merger went back then?
The merger with the kids, we got along. There was really not too many issues at all, any major issues that I can recall. I think some of the parents maybe didn't like the merger at first. But then I think some of them, you know, they saw, you know, the benefits and everything. And it was a controversial issue back then. But the kids, we all responded. I know people now that I would have never known if we would have never merged. So if there wouldn't have been a combination of consolidation, I wouldn't have got to meet a lot of new friends. So
do you see any similarities with the new school as opposed to Armstrong Central?
You know what? There was less resistance this time, I feel, between Ford City and Katanning. Back then, there was some resistance at first. They didn't want to merge. Yeah, that's what I can, you know, in the beginning it was whatever. Then whenever we were put together, everything was okay.
And I also think, too, you're starting with a new building, so it's new to everybody.
Exactly.
You're not moving one group of kids into Katanning and another group to Ford City. You're starting fresh, and everybody's going to be starting new together in a new environment, teachers, students, everybody. So
I agree.
Think that's a difference.
I agree. If there would have been a new building, I think things would have been a lot different in this area. It would probably stayed Armstrong Central. So, but no building was created.
And how do you think sports are going to be affected by this transition into a combined school?
I think there's going to be more players, or more students, we'll say, for teams. It's like a lot of these teams are struggling with their numbers. Football, we had a nice number surge in football this year. But some other sports, the numbers are down. So when you combine them, I think you're going to have more depth, and then you can create more teams. And hopefully it's going to create a competitive atmosphere, you know, within a team where people are going to have to fight for their position, try to earn their position. Sometimes you go in there and, you know, a kid doesn't have to look over their shoulder because there may be nobody there for them to compete against. So hopefully it creates that and creates a, you know, more competitive teams for our area.
Depth seems to be an issue within all the school sports, not even with Katanning, with all the Elderton and Ford City. But if we combine, I do feel like it would.
Some teams even struggled to even have a team because the numbers were so low. So hopefully this creates it, and there's those opportunities I talked about previously. We can have more opportunities for children to participate in all, you know, a variety of sports and maybe new sports that we don't even currently offer.
And I think going even beyond sports, classes. You know, we have a lot of electives that sometimes in our schedules can only fit one period a day. But if a student has a physics lab or a biology lab that period, they're not able to take that elective because it's the only time of the day it's offered. And hopefully when the schools come together, there'll be more flexibility with scheduling and allowing kids to pursue some of their interests with our electives and so forth as well.
Yeah, for instance, going back to the sports part, Elderton did not offer football. I mean, they had to do a co-op with West Shamokin, so that may have prevented, you know, a certain Elderton student not to want to play football. Mm-hmm. Or Katanning doesn't have boys volleyball. And sometimes, you know, they don't want to go down to Ford City. They don't want to go to another school. But if you're all in one house, you're all one one family basically inside the house as a school, it will make a easier bonding, you know, yeah. with the other students.
Back to the sports and still on the sports, are we going to make new sports facilities or are we going to use the current ones we have?
That is a good question. I believe the ultimate goal is to have new facilities, but I don't know if it's financially possible right now.
Yeah.
I've heard different rumors, and of course they're just rumors floating around.
Yeah.
So you never never know what to believe or not believe sometimes. But I think their goal is to have the facilities, but I think we'll use the current ones, at least initially. I could be wrong there too,
yeah.
So I don't want to start any rumors.
I don't know.
So do you think sports teams will be better when they are joined?
It's hard to say. It all depends upon how the kids react. And I think they're going to be stronger. I think when you combine, like I said, you're going to have competition now in the team, within the team, and hopefully that translates whenever we, you know, would play against another team.
And now we're going to take a short break. We'll be back in a minute to talk more about plans for the new school. Stay tuned.
Before I came to IUP, I had no idea what college would be like or what role I would play or where I'd be in the future. But when I came to IUP, everything changed. I met people who really made me feel like I belonged. I had great classes at a great nationally ranked university. Hi, my name is Megan Miller. I'm a fine arts major, and this is my university.
And we're back with our younger committee member, Eric Shiring. Eric, can you tell us what your role is in the committee?
Well, I serve as a student representative to the school board. So they chose me and the senior rep, Mark Wasilko, to be on the board to represent the student opinion for the election process of the school mascot and colors.
And what were the requirements to get on this?
Well, they chose the student council president and the student board representatives from each building, from Katanning and Ford City. And we came to the meetings to give our input for the student voices.
What do your peers think about you being on the board?
Well, I was only really vocal about my membership on the board when I wanted to hear the student opinions for the topics at hand. Like, I would ask the freshmen most often, because they'll be attending the school, what they wanted me to say, what the board should hear, what the committee should know about the student opinions.
And what input do you have at these meetings?
They're very supportive of us being involved as students. So they would ask what we thought of the questions at hand, what we thought should be considered in the voting process, all of those things.
Do you feel that your opinion as a student is valued?
I definitely do. We got to have a lot of input. There wasn't very much stress from the adults because we were students. They accepted us. They let us say what we felt should be said for the students.
And why do you feel that your input is important at these meetings?
Well, we were able to say a lot. We were able to contribute a lot. We were involved in the voting process for the narrowing down of the mascot choices, so we definitely had as much input as the rest of the members of the committee.
Well, that's our show for today. Thanks to our guests, Gretchen Contrail, Ed Morris, teachers at Katanning High School, and Katanning Junior Eric Shiring. I'd like to also thank all of the members of the committee made for planning the new school, who have been working hard to make our new school as great as possible. Special thanks to TV production students from Katanning High School, led by their teacher, Mr. Josh Miklas. Please join us again next week for another look at the Armstrong School District. For more information about what's going on in the district, please check us at the next time you're surfing the web. Have a great week.